In today's software world, we are relying on more tools than ever. Thanks to the implementation of AI, more and more software is being added to your tech stack every day. But keeping this data synced up and always representing the most current truth can be really difficult. That's why in this video, I'm going to be showing you an alternative to all of these siloed data repositories, and instead we're going to figure out a way to connect them all together so that we always have up-to-date information. If learning more about how to do this with no-code tools is of interest to you, stick around and let's get into it. Welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Gareth, and this is Gap Consulting. It's our mission to help you unlock the full potential of no-code tools. And in today's video, we're going to be taking a look at Whalesync, an amazing no-code tool that's going to help you connect multiple different data sources and keep them all synced. Now, before we get into the heart of things, I first want to invite you to join me for some templates. If you're ready to ditch spreadsheets forever and you want to get up and running quickly with no code, grab my free templates at gapconsulting.io/templates. And as an added bonus, we're actually going to be using one of the templates in today's video. So if you sign up there and grab those templates, you can follow along in our CRM template as we're going through this example. But without further ado, let's hop on into my screen and we're going to start from Google Sheets. Now, let's imagine that we've got some marketing efforts in our marketing department, and they are bringing in all of our website leads, and they're doing a lot of things to do this. They're bringing in stuff like SEO, they're running paid campaigns. They have all sorts of different ways that they're bringing leads into the business, ultimately getting people to opt into something on our website, and we're collecting this information here. First name, last name, email, and phone number. Now, let's suppose that the marketing team needs these outputs. They do something with them. Maybe they're creating lookalike audiences. Maybe they are, just refining their different marketing campaigns through a variety of ways. But ultimately, what they need is up-to-date information. But it doesn't stop there, because we need to pass this information from marketing over to the next team as well, right? We want to actually be able to, during the sales pipeline process, when our sales team is interacting with our new leads, we want to make sure that we're working from a source of truth. But let's imagine that instead of using Google Sheets, our sales team is over here in an Airtable CRM. Now, you'll notice that I'm here inside an Airtable interface, because we are truly leaning into interfaces a lot lately. It makes a ton of sense for you to not grant access to the underlying data when you're sharing information in Airtable. Instead, if we are in our sales team here, we can imagine that we've had the CRM shared with us, and we have specific permissions and specific records that we can see. So here I am in the template, and I'm not going to go through all the different components, but I am going to focus on our contacts. And you can see that we've got 10 different contacts here on our screen. They are in alphabetical order by the first name. So Daniel's here at the top, Sophia is at the bottom, and of course we can add new contacts manually into our sales CRM here. But let's imagine that inside of our process, what happens is, we're emailing with Daniel here, and we come to learn that his phone number is incorrect. It's actually 1098 at the last four of his phone number. So what are we going to do? Well, we can update it in our sales CRM, but what about marketing? What about keeping them up to date with the most correct information at all times? Well, thanks to Whalesync, we can do this very thing, so that now all I have to do as a sales representative, come in here and update my data. I'm updating my source of truth. And yet, over on the other side of the business, in the sales team, if we go into that CRM spreadsheet here, this is again in Google Sheets, wait just a moment, and there we go. Our phone number has now been updated for Daniel. So with this tool, we are able to then update information in both places. When it's changed in one area, automatically reflect that change in another or multiple other data sources. How do we get this set up? That's where Whalesync comes into play. Now, you can sign up for a free trial using the link that we share with this video. I'm going to go step by step into how we built this sync so that you can set up something similar. So you'll notice here that first we start with setting up the apps. So I've already connected both Airtable and Google Sheets. Doing this is very easy. Whalesync has set up step-by-step prompts so that when you're doing this, you just go and click through the different pages and give the Whalesync software the information it needs. Now, once you've connected to Airtable, and in this case, Google Sheets, now it's time to map this data. So if we were to start over again from scratch, let's first disable our sync. We have to turn it off before we can play around with this. But you'll see that we've set it up so that it's mapping these fields in Airtable to these fields over in our Google Sheet. Now the fields in Airtable are getting their names from the field names, whereas in Google Sheets, we're getting it from the first row. So if we flip back into Google Sheets, you'll see that my first row here has these headers, first name, last name, email, and phone number. So back in Whalesync, that is what we are mapping. It also has an auto mapping feature here that allows us to save a lot of time and not have to manually map all these fields. And when we set this up, we start with the table mapping. And I do want to point out that if you're trying to write information back to Airtable as well as to Google Sheets, well then when we make the selection, don't pick a view. So for example, if we wanted to set up a sync between companies in Airtable and a different database sheet in Google Sheets, well, we would need to make sure that we select companies here, not the view all companies. Now, the reason for this is when we go to write information back to Airtable, we can't write specifically to a view. We have to write to the data source, which is the table. So if you make this mistake and you choose the view, you won't be able to actually write information back to Airtable. And this is the true value of what we've built here, right? When we look back at this table mapping that we have here, this information, as you see by these arrows, is going both directions. Meaning if I make a change on the marketing side of things, it's going to be reflected back in Airtable. And if I make a change in Airtable, it's going to be reflected, as you already saw, back in Google Sheets. This is how Whalesync is changing the game in no code, because it is revolutionizing the way that we think about siloed data. Now, once we're all happy with the way that we've set this up and we make sure that it's sending information the right direction, either both directions, bidirectionally synced, or one way or the other. Once we're happy with it, we're gonna save and exit here, and we need to make sure to toggle this back on. So you can see that this is currently disabled because I was going in and making edits. Simply up in the upper right corner, activate the sync to make sure that it is running again. Now, once we have done that, so you can see that it's currently operating, it's syncing. Once we've done that, I want to take it out and give us a test so that we can see information coming from the spreadsheet back into our Airtable CRM. So if we go back into Airtable, we can see that we don't currently have anyone in here named Gareth. I can do a quick search here just to prove it. I'll bring this up, search contacts for my name, and we see nothing. So let me clear out that search, and we're gonna go now into our spreadsheet. This again is the one that marketing is using. And let's imagine that, you know, they have this tool where they have information coming in from our website leads. And we're gonna imagine that they are automatically having this data added to their spreadsheet, just like this. So I'll go ahead and plug my information in here, and I'll even leave the phone number blank for now. And all we have to do now is pop back into our CRM and wait just a few moments, because that sync is operating in the background, right? If you recall back here in Whalesync, we can see it's looking for changes, and pretty soon we're gonna see that the new information was spotted in our Google Sheets and will update here. Now it took just a moment, but that information is now reflected here. You can see that it's not properly synced up to a company, and I don't have a phone number, but I do have the name brought in with the right email address. So this is a great way for you to automatically connect these different siloed data sources and make sure that everyone's working from the same information. Now you might stop yourself here and think, well, why wouldn't I just build automation to do this? And the reason, frankly, is effort and cost. Because when you're setting up automations that are keeping this data synced between multiple sources, you have to do it in a way that when one source is updated, it sends an automation one direction, and then you duplicate that automation, but in reverse, for the opposite to be true. This is a lot to manage, a lot to maintain, and burns through a ton of automation. But with Whalesync, we don't have to worry about any complex automations. We just build the integration one time, and it is truly set it and forget it. Any changes here will be reflected in the other place, and vice versa. Now, I know we went pretty quickly in this video, but if you have questions, feel free to swing by our website. And of course, if you got value from this, give us a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. But most importantly, keep on building.